लेक्चर नंबर टू, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 2A फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड यू हैव टू अप्लाई ए प्लस बी प्लस सी होल स्क्वायर फॉर्मूला। सो ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी प्लस टू बी सी प्लस टू सी ए। ओके, बट बिफोर अप्लाइंग दिस फॉर्मूला यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द साइन। Either it is minus or plus, you have to directly assign the sign in question, okay? Like if you have 2x minus p plus c whole square, so you have a equal to 2x, b equal to minus p, and c is equal to c. Okay, now formula for this a plus b plus c whole square equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2a b plus bc plus c. Now we have to put the value of a, b, c. A square 2x means 4x square plus b square minus b square is b square, c square is c square because c equal to c, plus 2a, a into b, 2x into minus b, so minus 2ap, sorry 2xp minus 2xp. Next, BC, minus P into C, minus PC, then CA is 2CX, okay, this is the square of this, then we have to find out 2X plus P minus C, okay, similarly you have to find the second one, then subtract second part from the first, okay. Next, question number 4, question number 3 you have to complete by your own, okay. Do this question in your fair copy. You have to do the question in your fair copy as per the instruction. Whatever I am giving you, you have to do as per this. Okay. Question 4, second part. First part is again very simple. 1 by 3 minus 5x multiplied with 1 by 3 plus x. This is based on the identity directly here a minus b a plus b. We have to use a minus b a plus b, that is a square minus b square. So what is a? A is 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 square minus b square is 5x square. So our answer is 1 by 9 minus 25x square. Okay, move to third part. Third part is your homework again. A plus B minus B, so our answer is x to the power 6 minus 9. Next, fourth part, again very simple question, A to the power 4 minus 1 upon 5y and A to the power 4 plus 1 upon 5y. So our answer is A to the power 8 minus 1 upon 25y square. Okay, similarly, we have to do fourth part in your fair copy and first and second, third part in your rough copy, okay. Then move to next fifth question. Find the product. Again, very simple question. I am doing here first part of fifth question. We have x plus y, x minus y, x square plus y square. This is based on the identity a plus b, a minus b. That's why it is written as x square minus y square. Why it is? Because a plus b minus b is a square minus b square. Okay, then multiply it with x square plus y square. Again, this form is a minus b a plus b. Here a is x square, b y square. A minus b a plus b, a square minus b square of b. Okay, so it is x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. Second part is your homework in your fair copy. Okay, first you have to take the last two term a plus b a minus b, that is a square minus b square, then do the product with first part or first term a square plus b square, then it become a to the power 4 minus b to the power 4, and again product or multiply it with a to the power 4 plus b to the power 4. Next, move to question number 6. First part, state which of the following expression is a perfect square. Okay, this is very important question, because we have to find out which one is perfect square and which one is not. So for perfect square, we have three terms. If we have to square, then we must have three terms: a square plus b square plus 2ab. If here minus, then minus. Okay. First part is question number 6. First part: x square plus 8x plus 16. Okay. We have a square, we have b square. Okay. Now it must be in the form of 2ab. Okay. A square, it means a is x, b 4. So 2ab, this is the term which contains 2ab terms, 2 into x into 4, 2 into 4, 8x. So a plus b, this must be in the form of a plus b whole square. That's why it is written in the form of a plus b whole square. Here x, a equal to x and b equal to 4. So this is the square of x plus 4 whole square. So x square plus 8x plus 16 written as x plus 4 whole square. Next, second part: y square plus 3y plus 9. Here a square plus b square, it means a equal to y and b equal to 3. Then 2ab, okay, what we have, 2ab. Can it is written in the form of perfect square or not? No, because 2ab term must contain 6y. Why it is 2 into a into b. So this is written as 2, okay, 2 into a, y into b, 3. So it is 6y, and here gives 3y. So this is not in the form of perfect square. Okay, move to next part. Fourth part, third part is your homework, and fifth part also your homework. Fourth part we will discuss here. 4x square minus 2 plus 1 by 4x square. Okay. 4x square is written as 2x whole square, and minus 1 by 4x square is written as 1 upon 2x whole square plus minus 2. Now compare with a square plus b square minus 2ab. Minus 2ab. Compare this equation with this: 2x whole square plus 1 upon 2x whole square minus 2 into a into b. Cancel with this, so it forms a perfect square. So this is written in the form of a square plus b square minus 2ab. So this is the form of a minus b whole square, where a equal to 2x and b is 1 upon 2x. So it is written as 2x minus 1 upon 2x whole square. Okay, question number 6, third part and fourth part your homework in your fair copy. Next, move to seventh part. 4x square minus 12x plus k is a perfect square. Find the numerical value of k. Very simple question again. Seventh part, question number 7. Four x square minus 12x plus k. Question number 7. We have to find out the value of k so that it must be a perfect square. How we can find this? We have to find first of all a and b. Okay, this is a. Let this is a square. So it is written as a square. It is minus 2ab or either 2ab. Okay. This is must be 2ab term. So minus 2 into a. We have a. Because a equal to 2x. So we can put a as 2x. And rest of the term is 2 into 2, 4. 4x, then 3. plus k. Okay, so here if you compare this equation with minus 2ab, like this, minus 2ab equal to minus 2 into 2x into 3. So what is the value of b? Here, from here it is b. So the value of b is 3. So we have to find out the value of k. So it must be k. So it must be k equal to b square. For making it perfect square, k must be equal to b square. Why it is? So that we can take it as 2x whole square. Sorry, here 2x whole square minus 12x, that is minus 2ab plus k. K is b square. So b square is written as 3 square. That side is 9. So 2x square minus 12x plus 9. So we can write it as 9 or 3 square. Okay. So a minus b whole square. So 2x minus 3 whole square. Okay. So value of k. We have to find out value of k. So k equal to 9. So value of k equal to 9. Next,